How do animals eat? All animals need food in order to live and grow. What purpose do we need food? We need food in order to live and grow. Animals leaves, finding food is an important work it must do in order to survive. Without food, we can't survive. So that's why we need food. However, different animals differ in the body. Animals leaves, finding food is an important work it must do in order to survive. Without food, we can't survive. Without water, we can't survive. The air is also very, very important. However, different animals differ in the food they eat. They also differ in the way they get their food. They obtain their food from plants and animals. Food can be defined as anything solid or liquid, which when we swallow, digest it, and assimilate it in the body, provides it with essential substances called nutrients and keeps it well. It is the basic necessity of life. Food supplies energy, enables growth and repair of tissue and organs. It also protects the body from diseases and regulates body function. That's why we need food. There are 5 basic food groups suggested by Indian Council of Medical Research. They are cereals, grains and products, pulses and legumes, milk and meat products, fruits and vegetables, fats and sugars. We observe the cereals is energy-giving food. The pulses are growth-giving food. The vegetables and fruits are very good for health. Meat and milk is also very important for nutrients. When we observe the sugars and fats, it is needed to obesity. So we avoid the burgers and pizzas. Why do animals need food? Like humans, animals also need food to gain energy, to their cellular metabolism and other body functions. Animals have a wide variety of metabolisms for which they need food, which is converted into energy and is used into different forms of metabolism. What is metabolism? Metabolism is the process by which your body converts what you eat and drink into energy. By observing the animals, there are 2 kinds: wild animals and domestic animals. Wild animals will hunt their prey and get their food. Mostly wild animals are carnivores. Domestic animals, next one is domestic animals. Domestic animals will feed their food and eat it. They are mostly herbivores. By observing the food habits of different kinds of animals, they are divided into three groups: herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Herbivores means the animals which eat only the plant are called herbivores. Carnivores means the animals which eat only the animals are carnivores. The third one is omnivores, which means the animals eat both plants and animals are called omnivores. Birds are also omnivores. When you observe from protozoans to protozoans are unicellular organisms, it catches its food by separate mouthparts or separate tentacles. Mouthparts have some feather-like structures that are known as tentacles. The snakes swallow the whole prey or whole food. When we observe the beaks of different birds, the birds will use in different ways to catch the food material. When you observe the crane catches its prey in the water, it has a long beak to catch the food. But in the same way, when you observe the woodpecker, its woodpecker have a short, long and strong beak to remove the bark of the plants. The hidden insects are catch and eat it. When you observe the crows, the crows will eat both the rotten food material and the insects. So it is a omnivores, and it is also known as the scavengers of natural scavengers. When you observe the pigeons, have a small hook-like board, it will be used to remove the shell of the nuts. Now we observe about the food chain. A food chain explains which organisms eats another organism in the environment. What is a food chain? A food chain explains which organisms eat another organism in the environment is known as a food chain. The food chain is a linear sequence of organisms which nutrients and energies transfer from one organism to other. This occurs when one organism consumes another organism. It begins with producer organisms, follows the chain, and ends with decomposer organism. After understanding the food chain, we realize how one organism is dependent upon another species for survival. Now let us look at the other aspects of a food chain to get a better understanding. What is a food chain? A food chain refers to the order of events in an ecosystem where one living organism eats another living organism, and later that organism is consumed by another larger organism. The flow of nutrients and energy from one organism to another at different trophic levels forms a food chain. How can form a food chain? A food chain refers to the order of events in an ecosystem where one living organism eats another organism, and later that organism is consumed by another larger organism. The flow of the nutrients and energy from one organism to another at different trophic levels forms a food chain. The food chain also explains the feeding pattern or relationship between living organisms. Trophic level refers to the sequential stages in a food chain, starting with producers at the bottom, followed by primary, secondary, and territory consumers. Every level in a food chain is known as a trophic level. For example, how can the food chain starts? The food chain starts with the producers. Who are the producers? The producers are the plants. All green plants or green algae also prepare their own food. Preparation of food by the plants is known as autotrophous plants. Autotrophous. Autotrophs means the plants which prepare their own food is called autotrophs. But animals are heterotrophs. What is meant by heterotrophs? The heterotrophs means the animals depend on others. So the plants will only prepare their own food by in the presence of the sunlight, carbon dioxide, and chlorophyll, water. They prepare their own food is called autotrophs. Only plants are able to prepare their own food. The plants is also known as producers. The producers are in food chain is the basic level. Our base of the food chain is the plants. The second one is consumers, first consumers. Here is the first consumers are the plant eating animals. The plant eating animals are herbivores, are known as the first consumers. The energy is transformed from one trophic to another trophic. It will be decreased. The large trophic level is first producers. The second one is herbivores. The third one is the carnivores. Carnivores are third stage, and fourth stage, the omnivores. In the way of they divided in the food chain. And lastly, the decomposers. The decomposers will compose the nutrients and send into the soil, and it will be get back to the plants. Food chain consists of four major parts, namely the sun. The sun is the initial source of energy. Is the initial source of the energy in the world? The sun is the initial source of energy. It provides energy for everything on the planet. Producers in a food chain include all autotrophs such as phytoplankton, cyanobacteria, algae, green plants. This is the first stage in food chain. The producers make up the first level of a food chain. The producers utilize the energy from the sun to make food. Producers are also known as autotrophs, as they make their own food. Producers are known as autotrophs, as they make their own food. That's why they are known as producers or autotrophs. Producers are any plant or other organisms that produce their own nutrients through photosynthesis. Who are known as producers? Producers are any plant or another organisms that produces their own nutrients through photosynthesis. For example, all green plants, phytoplankton, and algae are some examples of producers in a food chain. Next thing is, after producers, we know about the consumers. Consumers are large organisms that are dependent on plants or other organisms for food. This is the largest part of a food web, as it contains almost all living organisms. It includes herbivores, which are animals that eat only plants, carnivores, which are animals that eat other animals. Parasites are those organisms that live on the other organisms by harming them, and lastly, the scavengers, which are animals that eat dead animals, carcasses. Here, herbivores are known as primary consumers. Who are known as primary consumers? The herbivores are known as for primary consumers, and carnivores are known as secondary consumers. The second trophic level includes organisms that eat producers. There are primary consumers or herbivores or organisms in the second trophic level. The first trophic level is producers. The second trophic level is first consumers, that is the herbivores. And third trophic level is carnivores, and fourth is herbivores. In last, decomposers. Decomposers are organisms that get energy from dead or waste organic material. What are the decomposers? Decomposers are organisms that get energy from dead or waste organic material. This is the last stage in a food chain. Decomposers are an integral part of a food chain, as they convert organic waste materials into organic materials like nutrient-rich soil or land. Who is rich the organic soil? By the decomposers. Decomposers are an integral part of a food chain. They convert organic waste materials into inorganic materials like nutrient-rich soil or land. Decomposers complete a life cycle. They help in recycling the nutrients as they provide nutrients to soil or oceans that can be utilized by autotrophs or producers. Thus starting a whole new food chain. Decomposers complete the life cycle that by the decomposers, the food chain will be complete, right? They help in recycling the nutrients as they provide nutrients to soil or oceans that can be utilized by autotrophs or producers. Thus, starting a whole new food chain. Next is the food web. Several interconnected food chains form a food web. How can food web be formed? Several interconnected food chains form a food web. A food web is similar to a food chain, but the food web is comparatively larger than a food chain. Occasionally, a single organism is consumed by many predators, or it consumes several other organisms. Due to this, many trophic levels get interconnected. The food chain fails to showcase the flow of energy in the right way. But the food web is able to show the proper representation of energy flow. As it displays the interactions between different organisms. When you observe a food web is several interconnected food chains. From your food web, a food web is similar to a food chain, but the food web is comparatively larger than a food chain. Occasionally, a single organism is consumed by many predators, or it consumes several other organisms. Due to this, many trophic levels get interconnected. The food chain fails showcase the flow of energy in the right way, but the food web is able to show the proper representation of energy flow as it displays the interactions between different organisms. The wonder world of ants. Ants do a lot of things. Their colony has large ant forces to do work. There are mainly workers, soldiers, and male ants. Ants do a lot of things. Their colony, there has a large ant forces to do work. They are mainly workers, soldiers, female and male ants in ants. The workers collect and maintain food stock for others. In the colony, along with several other duties. Just as we keep cows for milk, some species of ants keep a type of insects called aphids or honeydew. Now we know about the what we learn by doing this topic. By observing the lesson, all animals need food in order to live and grow. What we need animals? All animals need food in order to live and grow. Different animals eat different food. Different animals eat different food. They also differ in the way they get their food. They obtain the food from plants and animals. They obtain their food from plants and animals. Food can be defined as anything solid or liquid which, when swallowed and digested and assimilated in the body, provides it with essential substances called nutrients and keeps it well. Food supplies energy, growth, and the repairs of tissue and organisms. It also protects the body from diseases and regulates the body functions. Okay, now we have completed this lesson by observing what animals eat. Thank you, one and all. I will tell you all of it.